Hello, crafty budgeters, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Brittany. On this channel, we are working to craft a budget and a lifestyle to become debt free. Yo, happy day to you, whichever day you are watching this. This video normally and typically and will be going up today on Saturday, but your girl is doing a batch recording because I got some stuff happening that I will share throughout this video. Y'all, I am so excited to start this video. This video is about to be lit. This video is about to be hype. This video is about to be fire. We are going to be checking in for our first paycheck of November and then setting up our second paycheck of November. Also, like, how is it already going on the middle of the month? Like, again, these months are just flying by and I just need them to slow down just a little bit. Just a little bit. If you did not catch my last video that I put on, shout out to the Mom Life for creating this awesome collab with budgeters, YouTubers, planners, showing their workspaces, showing their filming setup. So y'all got a behind the scenes look at your girl's office where I film. If you didn't check that out, make sure that you look at it and then make sure that you check all of the awesome lineup videos that are out. They're great. I love seeing everyone's style, and she has some like powerhouse people on this collaboration. So that's really awesome. If you enjoy these types of videos, budgeting, planning out your money, goal setting, paying off debt, make sure that you subscribe to the Crafty Budgeter fam. We have fun over here. If you enjoy these types of videos, make sure that you also like and subscribe. Come on, Brittany. Like and comment. I respond back to all of your comments in a reasonable amount of time. I know I'm a little bit behind on commenting, but your girl will get it together and get caught up by the end of this weekend. So y'all, we are gonna jump right in to this check-in. Say hello to Sebastian. Sebastian's hanging out with us just for the beginning, and then, sorry Sebastian, move on over. Okay, so the way that I start my check-ins is that I first like to do a visual representation of how we did throughout the week, looking at our categories. These are the categories that we track every week: groceries, eating out, personal, gas, and miscellaneous. And you will see the colors represented throughout the weeks. I don't have the first week of November just because I didn't get a chance to do the video and I wasn't going back to do it, but you will see some colors happening for the first paycheck. So starting the 5th to the 11th. So the way that I do my weeks is Friday to the Thursday. So we're going to be checking in for this week, and then we'll dive a little bit deeper into like what the money breakdown is, but I don't necessarily walk through every single expense just because that takes up a little bit of time and I want to get right into some other things. So y'all, this is the budget kit. If you are still interested in it, it's up on the Etsy shop. It's a $10 budget kit. You get, I think, 10 or 11 pages in this kit. I think this is my top, it's in the top three favorite themes that I have done. I just love this like dark blue, just gives me like very fall themes. So let's check in with how we did. All right, so I brought you in close and personal so we can see how this week, this past week went. So here are our categories that I say that we track every week. And then I always do the starting amount. So this is what we started with at the beginning of the week. And now we're gonna see how much we spent and if we have any money left over. See if the red pen's gonna be coming out. What do you think? Red pen is happening? Is it gonna be all black everything week? Put your guesses down below. And all black everything week means that we didn't overspend in any categories and I get to use the black pen on every category. So for groceries, we budgeted $150 and we spent $144.06, which means that we have $5.94 remaining. Y'all, I just have to give a personal shout out. You know, I always do a shout out to Mr. Crafty Budgeter, the MVP of the fam, like just making it happen. Your girl is doing a lot. You're doing a lot with the Elevated Life Co. Definitely check that out. The pre-sales is happening in a couple of weeks. Ah, follow us on Instagram. But also working. I am doing that interim VP role of our team. Like, just not getting home at a good amount of time. Like, your girl's just doing a lot. And Mr. Crafty Budger has been stepping it up. Not like he hasn't before, but like to the point where I'm like, I give him this look and I'm like, wait a minute, handsome man doing all of the do's. Y'all, he has cooked every dinner for the past like 3 weeks. He gets my son up, takes him to school, picks him up, like just rocking it. And not saying that he hasn't done that before, but it's just like he's been taking on a little bit more than he normally has just because I've just been so busy with meetings and other things going on. So shout out, give a 2 snaps to Mr. Crafty Budgeter. He's doing his thing. I couldn't do this thing called life without him. And I'm realizing that, you know, the love languages, like tests, and there's like different types of love languages. I think my love language is like acts of service, or maybe that's not what it is. It's like, I gotta figure, I'll put it on the screen what the actual title is, but like, just knowing that he is taking on some of those things that like normally I would be doing, but your girl's trying to be boss lady and like mom and 50 million other things. And so he's just like picking up the slack. It just gives me a little like, oh, my heart just flutters a little bit. My stomach gets a little butterflies up in there. Okay, so personal, we budgeted $15 and I spent $7.27. And so, is that right? Okay, it's right. So, leftover is $7.73. I don't know why, like, Brittany, you do this as in Excel. Excel knows how to count, but for some reason when I was trying to do the math, I'm like, how is that? Oh, I know what I was doing. Whatever. Eating out always gets $50, and we spent $47.49, which means we have $2.51 remaining. Gas, we budget $100, and we spent $77.03, which means we have, wait a minute, $22.97 remaining. And then miscellaneous, we budgeted for myself $15 and I spent $13.78, which means I have $1.22 remaining. Y'all, do you see that? 2 snaps, all black, everything week. Do, 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 all black, everything week. Do, 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 do. Yay! And also, do you see your girl got some rollover money for Cash Stuffing Sunday? Y'all, so we did good for the first week of November. Now let's just look at the full budget quickly to see how we did overall. All right, so here is the budget for last week. I, again, didn't do a check-in with you, so I actually didn't write anything in. So everything is just the actual, not the budgeted. So, again, we have everything stays the same like normal. For the fixed expenses, I rolled over all of the monies from our check-in and put that on the variable expenses. You will see that personal and miscellaneous are a little bit different depending on the numbers because I also incorporate my husband's spending. Bills got $100, and then buffer, we spent all of it. The buffer got hit really hard. I had an easy pass, like, charge, or what do you call them? Like, I went through, and I guess it didn't read my, I forgot to put up the easy pass tracker, whatever, and it charged me $15, and that $15, I've been just holding on to it since August. Like, I haven't paid it. Don't do that, y'all. Pay your bills when you need to and pay it on time. And then when I went in, it was like, oh, actually, you have another charge, and it totaled, like, $50. I'm like, you've got to be kidding me. And then I don't even know what another $25, I spent like $25 on something. I can't remember. But anyway, those are our totals with remaining. And then when you come down, everything stayed the same. You saw this on Cash Stuffing Sunday. We had $40 that we are rolling over, just basically keeping in our checking account for any other expenses that we didn't account for. It goes into that. So y'all, we did really well last week. So now let's set up our budget for the second paycheck of November. All right, y'all. So here is the setup for the second paycheck in November. The way that I start my breakdowns is that I start with the starting balance. I don't share our mortgage, our salaries. I don't share what we put to tithe. Those are just things that we keep private, but this is the amount that we are starting with. Grateful for this amount, grateful for every paycheck that we receive. So when we look at our fixed expenses are those expenses that come out every month. Basically, you know what I say, if you don't pay it, someone's going to be calling you, someone's going to be turned off, you're about to get a bill in the mail saying, where's my money at? So these are the fixed expenses. So daycare stays the same every week, gym, Apple, timeshare, Hulu, and then our electric bill. And last month I realized that, y'all, I don't know what happened, but I apparently didn't pay my electric bill 2 months ago. And so the reason why it was so high, it was like 200 and something, is because it was like, Brittany, you didn't pay. What in the heck? I don't know what happened. You know, every like now and again, even though I'm so organized and like having everything together, I always like, I forget some stuff, but I'm also like, where's my reminder? Like, give me a call, send me a text or something. Normally you blow up my phone, people blow up my phone all the time, but that's what happened. So I was making sure I was on, I'm going to be on it this week and this month. So that all comes to $523.87. I take that from the starting balance, and that gives us $1,300 to work with for our variable expenses and the plan. So for our variable expenses, doll, do you see this? Do you see what your girl is working with? So groceries is typical, $150. Eating out though, you know, eating out normally only gets $50, but this is the weekend that my husband and I are doing a little weekend getaway, enjoying some quality time together at our timeshare place. It's like an owner's weekend type thing. And so, y'all, I'm really excited. My son's going to the grandparents' house. Your girl's getting a little R&R. And I was making sure that, like, I really take R&R seriously this weekend because your girl's tired. Your girl's tired, and I really want to just enjoy, spend time with my husband, like enjoy just where we are going. And so, yeah, eating out some more just because we got to get some food. So $150 gas. I gave additional $50 because we are traveling, so I want to make sure we have enough money for that. Personal is getting 50, miscellaneous is getting 50, and that's split between my husband and I for each category. Bills is getting $100. We are putting $100 towards our bills category every week because at the end of the month is our AES bill, which is $469. And so we put a little bit aside every week to make sure that when that expense comes out, it's not a hard hit. Normally, y'all, remember, we would be saving up and doing the same thing for our car, $629, but your girl paid that off last month. And then the buffer is $100. So I got a phone call, so I don't even know where I left off at, but I think I said $100 buffer, and then that gives us a total of $750. So then I take the $750 from the remaining of the fixed expenses, and that gives us $550 that we are working with. And then this is the plan. So what are we doing with the $550? It is going to, like normal, our debt snowball, but typically our debt snowball is $250, but I have a little bit of money in our paycheck, a little bit extra, so $400, the normal $50 for sink emergency funds, and then sinking funds gets $100. So that comes to $550. We are a zero-based budget family, which means every dollar, every penny, every cent has a place to go. And y'all, that is the budget set up for this week. I must tell you that, like, I am so excited. While I love this My Budget Kid and everything, and I love just the planner that I've created, y'all, as I'm going through this, I cannot wait to start using the Elevated Life Co. Workbook Duo. I can't wait. December into January, I'm going to be just so hyped because it's happening. Y'all, make sure you follow the Elevated Life Co. to see all that our new workbook, Taylor Budgets, and I have been working really hard on. Well, it's already done. The books are about to be finished with the production company. Like, I'm just so hype. So, if you enjoyed this video, make sure that you like and comment. Make sure that you subscribe to the Crafty Budgeter fam. We have fun over here. I will see you tomorrow. You will see me in the same clothes because I'm literally about to film that right now because your girl's taking a little vacation. So have a great rest of your day. Be blessed. See ya. Bye-bye.